in the cool, cool, cool of the evening. Tell them I'll be there in the cool, cool, cool of the evening.
Hi, I'm Bob Powell. Welcome to Food, Friends, and Fun. Well, it's already May, and we've got quite a few things to celebrate this month.
Yes, May's got a lot of holidays. We've got Cinco de Mayo and the Kentucky Derby. Bob, remember that party we went to
where
they had mint juleps on one side and margaritas on the other, and it was just a lot of fun.
I think I remember it. Anyway, fun fact of the day. Did you know that there's a holiday for every day of the year? And there's a holiday for every month of the year. And they run from the sublime to the ridiculous.
When I was working, my supervisor, Joseph Kim, got the biggest kick out of the holiday of the day. I think his favorite was National Donut Day. We told him every day it was National Donut Day, so he'd go out and get donuts, but he got smart after a while.
Anyway, here's some examples. You ready?
I am.
May is National Blood Pressure Month.
Blood Pressure Month, yes.
What's that all about? But it is also National Hamburger Month, National Barbecue Month, and National Salad Month.
So from my perspective, you barbecue a hamburger, eat it with a salad, and then you take your blood pressure?
I guess. Now on to the holidays. May 3rd is, and I'm not making this up, Lumpy Rug Day. May 4th is Candied Orange Peel Day.
But May 4th is also Star Wars Day. May the 4th be with you. So watch Star Wars and bring your lightsaber.
May 5th is Hoagie Day as well as Cinco de Mayo. So eat your hoagie with salsa and chips.
But we have May 6th, which is No Diet Day. May 11th is Eat What You Want Day. Yay! Along with May 16th, No Dirty Dishes Day. So I guess you're free to eat out all month. But May 31st is National Macaroon Day. So enjoy those macaroons, and if you have enough money, buy some macarons as well.
May 11th is also Twilight Zone Day. You're traveling through another dimension, a dimension of sight and sound. Oh, never mind that.
Yeah, we all know that Twilight Zone is Bob's favorite. Anyway, and then May 12th, the next day, is Limerick Day, and May 13th is Leprechaun Day. Don't you think those should be in March and not May?
Yes.
I don't know.
Okay, May 16th is National Sea Monkey Day.
Sea Monkey Day, yeah, so celebrate those sea monkeys.
May 22nd is Buy Instrument Day. May 25th is National Wine Day. Now that makes sense.
Okay.
And May 26th is International Jazz Day. I think those celebrations go together, don't you?
I do too. Yeah. But today we're celebrating Mother's Day.
We have skits and songs celebrating Mother's Day and relationships with their offspring.
But since it's Mother's Day, the kitchen is closed. We're on strike, so go to brunch. All right?
Exactly. And we have a skit for Mother's Day featuring Cheryl Strich and Barbara Powell. It's from the classic comedy album, When You're in Love, the Whole World's Jewish. Here's A Call from Long Island.
Hello.
Hello, Mama.
Sweetheart, how are you?
I'm just terrible, Mama, just terrible.
Oh, what's wrong? Tell Mama.
Oh, Mama, we're snowed in here. The car wouldn't start. And the children, they're both coming down with the measles. And the doctor can't come until 5 o'clock. On top of that, 20 ladies from my Hadassah chapter are coming at 1 for lunch. The freezer's broken, all the food is spoiled, and the house is a mess. Mama, what am I gonna do?
Oh, don't worry, darling. Mother is here. First of all, I'll go to the market and I'll buy what to eat. Then I'll take the subway to the Long Island Railroad. It's only an hour and a half on the train.
On the train, but Mama.
Oh, please, darling, I don't mind. An hour and a half is an hour and a half, not a problem. Then I'll get off at this train. I'll take the bus. I'll walk the 14 blocks from the bus stop to your house. And for you, my darling, I'll put the children to bed. And for you, sweetheart, I'll change the sheets. I'll give the kids an aspirin so they shouldn't yell. And then, my darling, I'll clean your house. And I'll make a nice meal for those 20 ladies who are coming for dinner or for lunch. Don't worry, sweetheart, Mother is here.
Oh, Mama, I feel so much better. Thank you so much.
This is what a mother is for, but I have a question for you.
Yes?
If it's snowing and the car wouldn't start, how does Sam get to work today?
Sam?
Sam.
What's Sam?
Sam, your husband.
But my husband's name is Paul. Is this Tremont 71176?
No, this is Tremont 71177.
Does that mean you're not coming?
Parkinson's disease is a neurological movement disorder affecting an estimated 1 million Americans, including many under age 40. It has no cure. Parkinson's is not limited to how a person moves. It can also cause symptoms like depression, fatigue, and impaired speech. Today, there is a new diagnosis every 9 minutes, though Parkinson's can be present for years before being diagnosed. The American Parkinson Disease Association is the largest grassroots network in the United States, working to help ease the burden and find the cure. For more than 50 years, APDA has funded pioneering research and provided critical support to those affected by Parkinson's. Visit apdaoptimism.org today to find out how you can help millions live with dignity and optimism. Your action today will help APDA put an end to Parkinson's disease.
The next number is from the musical Chicago, featuring Barbara Powell, Estelle D'Annunzio, Sandy O'Connor, and Madeline Enright. They'll be singing When You're Good to Mama. Sounds familiar, doesn't it?
Ladies and gentlemen, the keeper of the keys, the countess of the clink, the mistress of Murderer's Row, matron, Mama Morton.
Ask any of the chickies in my pen. They'll tell you I'm the biggest mother hen.
Well, she's the mother.
I love them all and all of them love me. Because the system works, the system called reciprocity.
Got a little motto, always sees me through. When you're good to mama, mama's good to you.
There's a lot of favors I'm prepared to do. You do one for mama, she'll do one for you.
They say that life is tit for tat, and that's the way I live. So I deserve a lot of tat for what I've got to give.
Go, girl.
Don't you know that this hand washes that one too? When you're good to mama, mama's good to you.
If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for mama, and she'll get hot for you.
When they pass that basket, folks contribute too. You put in for mama, she'll put out for you.
Oh!
The folks atop the ladder are the ones the world adores. So boost me up my ladder, give, and I'll boost you up yours.
Let's all stroke together
like the Princeton crew. When you're stroking mama, mama's stroking you.
So what's the one conclusion I can bring this number to?
When you're good to mama,
had a skit with a mother and a daughter. We had a phone call. Now we have letters from a mother from Long Island and her son in California, played by Evelyn Suskin and Steve O. Hall. They both performed in Grandparents' Revenge, and she played his mother in that, and Steve O. was the son. Take a look.
December 3. To Irving Bloom, Missing Persons Bureau, Los Angeles, California. Dear Irving, 2 weeks have gone by since you moved to California, and I haven't heard from you. Please, let me know if you're dead or alive. Love, your concerned mother. Please, P.S., call me.
December 17th. Dear Mother, please don't write to him anymore in the care of the Missing Persons Bureau. 3 huge cops knocked down my door, and they beat the crap out of me. Haven't you done enough damage? You're sucking the life out of me. Your ex-son, Irving.
December 22. Dear Irving, how long are you going to blame me for the breakup of your marriage? That ex-wife of yours hated me from the day I moved into the apartment next to you. By the way, I think I had a small stroke last week. Call me. Every day of silence is another nail in my coffin. Love, your agonized mother.
January 6th. Dear Mother, I'm tired of the police beating me up every time you write. So from now on, use P.O. Box 26, L.A., California. And I will never, ever forgive you for giving Brenda $50,000 to leave me. Now I know why Dad died so young. He wanted to. I never want to hear your voice again, Irving.
January 11th, Irving, my darling son, my life, and now P.O. Box 26. I only hope and pray that one day you will have children who will break your heart as you broke mine. By the way, I heard that trashy ex-wife of yours went to Paris to become a model. She'll never make a dime with those hips. Love, your heavy-hearted mother.
January 19th. Dear Mother, stop writing me. You get me so upset, I can't even concentrate on my poetry. Your son, Irving.
January 23. Dear Irving, about your poetry, which is another thing that's eating me alive, believe me, you're not gifted in that area. Come home and get back into accounting. Then I can hold my head up high. Love, your mother who risked her life bringing you into this world. February 5th. I read your poem to the girls at Mahjong. They think maybe you should take Prozac. Did I mention anything about my chest pains? Oh, your ailing mother.
February 13th. Dear Mother, I called your doctor and he said you're as healthy as a horse. How many sons, besides me, took their mother to the prom? And don't even think about coming out here. You'll never find me. Irving.
Dear February 23rd. Dear Irving, if I have to go home to house, I'll find you. There is nothing stronger than a mother's love. February 28th. Dear Irving, even though it is cold and icy, and I have bad knees, I think I'll go out and check on airfare to California. Love, Mother.
March 29th. Dear Mother, somebody broke into my apartment and all they stole were pictures of Brenda. I can't believe it. How'd you find me? I must know. Irving.
April 29th. Dear Irving, I really can't tell you, but lately I seem to be getting visions and powers I never knew I had. Love, your supernaturally gifted mother.
May 4th. Mother, you're giving me the creeps. I'm changing my name and I'm moving again. It's Irving for now, but not for long. You'll never find me.
May 22nd. Dear poet, formerly known as Irving, give up. I can see your every move. I do not know how I got this power, but you'll never be able to escape me again. Besides visions of you, I get HBO. Your evolving mother.
May 26th. Is this all a bad dream? Let go! Get out of my life! June 17th. Dear Mother, I haven't heard from you in 3 weeks. That's not like you. What's wrong? July 3rd. Another 2 weeks have gone by and I still haven't heard from you. Are you sick? I'm starting to worry. Your loving son, Irving.
July 10th. Dear Irving, I've been thinking it over. You need your freedom. I'm cutting you loose. Love, your enlightened mother.
July 17th. Dear Mother, what do you mean you're cutting me loose? Something doesn't sound right. What's going on? Your son, Irving.
July 24th. Dear Irving, you'll never believe it. I met a man and I'm getting married. His name is Akbar and he's from Sri Lanka. I've never been so happy in my life. By the way, I ran into your ex-wife, Brenda. She's much nicer than I remembered. Your mystically enhanced mother.
July 27th. Dear Mom, who is this Akbar? Something's dreadfully wrong. Why are you using such spooky words and why do you suddenly seem so disturbingly serene? I'm coming home and don't do anything without me. Your devoted son, Irving.
Irving Bloom returned to his mother's apartment on August the 2nd. It was empty except for this message scrawled on the wall.
Dear Irving, if I was meant to be here, I would be. But I'm not, so I wasn't. Love, your enlightened mother. P.S. Eat something.
Oy vey!
Hi, my name is Beth Perrick, and I'm chairperson of the Thrive Project. The mission of our Thrive Project is to capture moments of living here in the village. Our vision is to inspire quality of life in every chapter of our lives. If you're interested in participating and becoming a part of the Thrive Project, please check out channelthrive.com.
Today we have a very special guest with us, none other than Irma Bombeck. Irma, welcome to the program.
Oh, thank you, Bob. I'm very happy to be here.
You know, you've led a very interesting life. So why don't you tell us something about it?
Well, my father died when I was 9, and my mother was only 25 years old because she had me when she was 16. And it was the Great Depression, but my mom just put on her overalls and got a job in a factory. And we moved back in with her family. That was a lot of fun. So I got married early, but very quickly had 3 children. I loved being a mom, but to the outside world, I was just a housewife. Motherhood, it's the second oldest profession. Well, almost everything we do is done behind closed doors, like the first. Unlike the first, there's no money in it.
No, there isn't. And it's probably not easy being a domestic goddess.
No, it's not. and I wasn't one of those women that pretended that it was simple to be a mother. It isn't easy. Any parent who has taken a trip with a kid who kicked the back of the seat for 50 miles knows what it's like to think about dropping them off in the desert.
So when did you start writing about it?
Well, when my youngest started kindergarten, I was 37 years old, and my excuse for everything had just gotten on the school bus. Well, I was too old for a paper route, and too young for Social Security, and too tired for an affair. So, writing a column for Housewives was what I could do.
But you took a whole different approach, didn't you?
Well, I didn't whitewash motherhood. I mean, if there's a mangled fork in the drawer, we get it. And if you're frying an egg and the yolk breaks, oh, that's ours. We give the lean meat to our husbands, the front seat to our mothers, and the last piece of cake to the kids. And if another mother says, "Would you like a little piece of advice, dear?" Like it or not, we're gonna get it. Yes, we are. And it's really kind of a ridiculous lifestyle if you think about it. But if you can't fix it, you gotta laugh at it. And if you can laugh at it, you can live with it.
Absolutely.
I got a lot of letters from a lot of mothers, including mothers in prison.
Prison.
Yes, listen to this. "Dear Irma Bombeck, you may not want to hear from the likes of me. I am serving a life sentence for killing my own child. I have read all your columns in our library several times. Had I known that mothers could laugh at these things, I probably wouldn't be where I am now."
Hmm. Wow.
Yeah, I keep this one to remind me of the very thin line between pain and laughter. And much as I complained in print about staying home with the kids, I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Oh, I wish I could go back to that Mother's Day that I got a shoebox containing a baseball card, and the gum was still in it.
The best part.
Yeah. And then one day, they leave. And you finally get to straighten up their room nice and tidy, and you step back and think, oh, now, I just want it to stay that way. And then it does.
Yes, it does.
Well, it was during that period that my mother and I became very close. She's the most beautiful woman I know. Every line in her face has been earned one by one. And you know, it took me a while to realize that our mother-daughter roles had reversed. One day I was driving in the rain and I had to slam on my brakes, and my arm shot out to protect her like she was a child. But then here lately, my daughter's been driving with me in the car, and she slammed down her brakes, and she shot her arm out to protect me.
My daughter does the same thing.
It's the big switch.
Yeah.
Oh, so soon. But that's what life's all about, isn't it? Changes, letting go. I mean, who wants to live or die with regrets? Think about all those women on the Titanic who waved away the dessert cart.
Oh, come on now. Well, that's food for thought. Listen, Irma, thanks very much for being with us today. You have inspired generations of women all over the world.
Oh, Bob, thank you very much for having me. And I want to wish all the mothers out there a very happy Mother's Day. You earned it.
Diane's Hallmark is a family-owned Gold Crown store that is much more than just a card store. Our women's department has apparel, accessories, and jewelry featuring Vera Bradley and Bagalini handbags. Our religious department carries many different Christian books and Bibles, plus a great selection of Christian gifts. Of course, we have a large selection of cards and gift wrap as well. come in and experience our personalized service.
One bright and guiding light that taught me wrong from right, I found in my mother's eyes. Those baby tales she told of pathways paved in gold, I found in my mother's eyes. Just like a wandering sparrow of heart to go, I walk the straight and narrow to reach my goal. God's gift sent from above, one bright, unselfish love, I found in my mother's eyes. I found in my mother's eyes. Just like a wandering sparrow, heart untold, I'll walk the straight and narrow to reach my goal. God's gift sent from above, one true, unselfish love, I found in my mother's eyes. I found in my mother's eyes.
My name is Beth Parrick, and I'm chairperson of the Thrive Project. The mission of our Thrive Project is to capture moments of living here in the village. Our vision is to inspire quality of life in every chapter of our lives. If you're interested in participating and becoming a part of the Thrive Project, please check out channelthrive.com.
Well, that's our show for me, and what a group of performers we had with us today.
We sure did. I want to thank everybody who performed on this show. We have Evelyn Siskin as Mrs. Bloom and her son, Irving, Steve O'Hall. We had the stylings of Estelle D'Annunzio, Madeline Enright, and Sandy O'Connor singing When You're Good to Mama in honor of our friend Benji Johnson. And then we had Frank Van Wickle, who sang My Mother's Eyes so beautifully for us. And then we have Kate Jacobs, who was Irma Bombeck. Thank you so much for joining us today, you guys. You guys did a great job, and Happy Mother's Day!
Happy Mother's Day!
Tell them I'll be there in the cool of the evening. Better see the chef in the party, he's getting the blow on. Singing fills the air. If there's room for one more, then you need me for sure. And you can tell them I'll be there.